Welcome back to the Sixth Gear Garage. Today, we're going to take a look at the new MIG205 Pro by Arc Captian.
So let me show you everything that comes in the box, starting with the ground cable. And over here, we have the electrode holder. Here is the MIG torch, and it comes with an extra bag of parts. We've got different size tips here, a nozzle and diffuser. Here is a liner for the MIG torch. We've got three different rollers, and each roller has two different sizes on it. Over here, we have the gas regulator and a hose. It comes with a 2-pound spool of wire, and the machine has this 220/240 plug on it, but if your workspace doesn't have that outlet, you can always put this adapter on there to take it down to a 110/120 outlet. And there is a cover to cover the machine when it's not in use and keep it clean. There is an optional TIG torch as well as an aluminum spool gun that you can use to weld aluminum with this, but I'm only going to use it to weld steel, so I'm going to show you how to set it up as a MIG welder. Connect the MIG gun. And we're going to use the positive polarity. I like how this swivels. Let's check which roller we have in here. So each roller has two sides. This one has 0.8 and 0.9, both V-groove. The size wire that I'm using requires the 0.9, so that's actually gonna face to the inside, which is the exact way it came from the factory, so it was good to go. And I just noticed that this spool is on backwards. It's gonna come down from the top to go in. I want it to actually come in from the bottom to go in. So I'm gonna switch this around. And cut. I didn't catch this earlier, but they actually include a built-in LED work light inside the unit to help you see what you're doing. By the way, here's a look at that cover, and it's pretty heavy-duty canvas. I like it. It's got a pocket in the side here, and it even opens up in the top, so you can pick it up by the handle and move it. And the ground. And around here on the back of the machine is the gas line hookup. And I'm gonna wait before I hook up this gas regulator to my tank until I move all this over here to this side of the garage where my 220 outlet is located. And yeah, you can use this on a 110 style outlet as well, but to get the full capabilities of the machine, you're gonna wanna use 220. I'm gonna be welding new rear quarter panels onto this rusty 1985 4Runner, and 110 is fine for sheet metal like this. But for welding any thicker materials or doing any kind of framework, you're gonna want that 220. But for now, while I have everything over at the workbench, let's take a look at the features of the MIG205 Pro. So right off the bat, it lets us know that we're hooked up to a 120 volt outlet. We're currently in MIG mode, although if you push the mode button, you'll see there's the option for the spool gun, the lift TIG, or stick welding. Over here on the right, this SYN button. If I press that, that switches into synergic mode. If I press it again, we go back into separated mode. When in synergic mode, the welder will auto match preset current and welding voltage. So it's great for beginners. If I go back into separated mode, there is no relation between the wire speed and the voltage. And that will allow you to fine tune the settings as you see fit. Over here, we can cycle through the different modes, 2T, 4T, or spot. I prefer 2T. If you go back into synergic mode for a minute here, you can see there are different wire settings you can choose from, as well as your different wire material. So in separated mode, by pushing on the dial itself, there's different ways you can adjust the current. You can go by wire speed, metal thickness, or there's actually ways to save different preset parameters, up to 10 available. And over on this side, if you push this dial, you can choose different voltage, burnback time, or inductance. And Arc Captian also has a downloadable app to control all these parameters from your smartphone. And that's gonna take me some time to figure out, so I'll go over all of that in a separate video. Let's go weld. I pulled a couple pieces of old Toyota frame from my scrap bin. And there's a thick side and a thin side. Looks like the thin side is about 2 millimeters thick. And the thick side here is 4 millimeters thick. And Arc Captian makes it really easy for you to determine your settings because everything you need to know is on the inside of this door. So to find the best settings, I'm gonna be welding steel, and then I'm using an argon CO2 mix. So go across here. Here is my welding wire that I'm gonna use, and I'm gonna be welding 4 millimeters. So come down here, and I've got 21.3 volts and 452 inches per minute. So now we just find 452 and 21.3. First, I'm just gonna throw a tack on it. Let's clean it up and take a look. It's definitely not going anywhere, but I could use a little more heat. I'm kind of fat right here on this end. But this is also double walled, so I'm sure that absorbs some of the heat on this one side here. My next weld is gonna be on the 2 millimeter section. So same as before, go across, we're using argon. This is our wire size. And we're looking at 17.4 volts and 268 wire speed. Actually, instead of doing separated again, let's try the synergic setting. So the important setting in synergic mode is to get the wire speed dialed in, which I did here. You can go through all the different ones and then the correct gas that you're using. And there's not much in the manual about this setting, but I guess it just adjusts on the fly. So I've never used it before. Let's give it a shot and see how it goes. So there's how it looks. I was kind of changing my speed and stopping and going to see if the machine would keep up, and it did. I did burn through a little bit at the very end. Here's a look at the other side. But as far as using the synergic mode, I think it's a great match for a beginner welder.
The things I like most about this MIG205 Pro are definitely the new LED screen with everything you need to control at your fingertips. And I also really like the design of this new case. And of course, most of all, I like how easy it is to use. I'll put a link to the MIG205 Pro down in the description, as well as a discount code for you to save some money at checkout. And don't forget to check back, because I am gonna add a second video showing the app and the smartphone features and how that connects to the welder. Thanks for watching.